Before Aware was even founded, the co-founders and I recognized there was a profound change happening across the entire business landscape. It used to exist primarily across our entire email platform, and suddenly it was beginning to shift into these new modern collaboration communication systems like Microsoft Teams and Slack and Cisco WebEx and Google. And that was bringing a new set of challenges, but also great opportunities to the enterprise.
Some of the biggest challenges facing C-suite executives is the rate at which data is being thrown at the company.
So this unstructured data is uniquely different. These systems produced a massive data exhaust with a metadata structure that was unlike anything else.
Every collaboration tool has its own unique way of grouping content and allowing conversations and threads to happen. And we need to deal with all of that data. Last but not least is a high volume and unpredictable volume pattern.
The second piece we saw was the human behavior difference. So enterprises really have never had to think about this human behavior that lives inside the content of this data. We also now see a data set where work and social conversations collide. And there's a mix of that, and it is still a system of record for these enterprises.
Extracting context and meaning from the constant stream of human collaboration data is no small task.
The major boulders that come together to make their technology what it is today, right? And if you look at it, step back and look at it, it's fundamentally an ingestion subsystem, a data fabric, we call it an intelligent data fabric, and then there's the Aware ML platform. So let's look at ingestion. So ingestion, as the name signifies, the process of acquiring data into the Aware platform. And the ingestion subsystem uses various mechanisms like webhooks, API, or even file uploads to acquire the data.
We have started with unstructured data and done a lot of work to normalize the data to a single taxonomy, which will then allow our customers to manage multiple collaboration platforms and all of their collaboration data.
And some of these messages are very complex. They have embedded files, they can have images, videos, and so on. So this ingestion subsystem was purpose-built to scale and perform to be able to ingest that amount of data. So once the data comes in, what the ingestion subsystem does is basically parse, validates, and then formats the data into a canonical format. So as the data flows through the rest of the Aware platform, they can be put in the right context for the ML models to make sense of them. And once the whole, you know, canonical object is ready, it is handed off to the core storage component, which we call the intelligent data fabric.
I think one of the unique things of our intelligent data fabric is it is not just a data lake and analysis engine. It is built from the ground up to be able to deal with the real-time monitoring and risk profile that this data has in addition to its data analysis profile. The intelligent data fabric was designed around being able to store multiple kinds of data. From the point we get the content in our door, managing it through encryption, storage, and securing, scoring and labeling all of the data with the relevant pieces. We were able to do that with sustaining sub-second response time on loading individual pieces of content for display on the screen. This tail of multiple use case scenarios that we've incorporated into the base of our product allows us to both do near real-time monitoring and remediations, as well as long-term trend analysis, archiving when necessary for legal holds or other use cases. All of that is capable of doing in our single platform, allowing our customer to interact with all of their collaboration data with a single set of rules and a single set of tools.
One of the things that I think makes Aware unique and how we've approached actually developing and putting into production machine learning models is that we have thought about it holistically in terms of how do we get a model to production in such a way that a customer can use the insights that we derive from the model, but we can also at the same time develop iterate and innovate on models and ideas quickly. At a top level, what makes this possible at Aware is that our machine learning platform really has three major components: the data platform, the ML data platform, the ML operations platform, and the ML team. We have approached it holistically in the sense that we have access to data. It's relevant data, which is key. It's timely, which is also key. We have methods of filtering, sorting, normalizing, anonymizing all of these data, then getting it to the models that matter, whether or not it's detecting the topic of a conversation, whether it's detecting whether or not there's a screenshot in a particular image that was shared on Slack or Teams. Then we can get that in an automated fashion to our models, do the detection, and then critically back into the product. What makes this possible at Aware is that our machine learning platform that allows data science autonomy, so developers, engineers, machine learning engineers can access the types of data and iterate on ideas as quickly as possible. It also has a scalable architecture that we can query billions of customer messages or images in a timely fashion. It scales to petabyte scale. Critically, it supports access patterns that data scientists and machine learning engineers need in order to develop their models and their ideas. Then we have a machine learning operations platform that allows, first off, data scientists to interact with the data. It allows data scientists, machine learning engineers to orchestrate complex types of workflows across large sets of data. It allows data scientists and machine learning engineers to spin up the types of resources they need it. So they don't have to go through a security process. They don't have to go through a gatekeeper in IT to do end-to-end data science and machine learning work. Companies also need to be thinking about whether or not they should be buying or building these type of features. They should be looking to experts to build those things instead, and then focusing their machine learning dollars and expertise on the subject matters that they know.
This data represents some of the most sensitive, even personal and company data that we can have. And so we need to treat it with respect every time we touch it.
How do you give the right level of access to the right user at the right time so that they have the information they need at their fingertips to make business decisions, but also while maintaining the privacy and sensitivity of some of the data that lives in these systems?
It was built from the ground up with security in mind. Every piece of content that we have is encrypted. It's important that that data is never represented or stored anywhere that could be accessed by anyone except for our customers. And we deal with that in a way that allows us to encrypt each individual piece of content, secure it specifically to that tenant, allow that tenant to manage their keys.
Our data, our ML data platform, deals with those things like encryption, security, access controls, like any data platform should.
We built throughout the platform from the very beginning all the way to the end user applications, a security layer that ensures proper governance, security, and data privacy along the life cycle of this data.
What is so important about having this unified and holistic approach to machine learning at Aware is that it really gets back to our core mission. We are able to provide them insights into how work gets done that is not possible without the ML platform.
The way it has been built, it is very easily extensible to handle multiple domains. Today, we look at risk, governance, compliance, and also employee listening, right? Because we are tapping onto the source of conversations, it can just scale to different problem domains. It is so much power in the hands of the CISO, the CIO, and the CEO.